Are you going to have a bona fide temper tantrum, or are you going to praise God? Pat Love with Pat's Two Cents. Listen, this is during our chat. Andre decided to praise God purposefully through her tears instead of expressing how she really felt. And as a result, she got a revelation. Now, you got to hear it because it segues into some really hilarious stories and some hilarious analogies of how God teaches us not to go too far with our little temper tantrums. You got to hear this.
Profound in that moment to go, wait, hold on, this is not going to kill me. He knows what he's doing. You know what image got in my head? A husband and a wife in bed facing opposite directions.
Yes.
It was kind of funny that I got that image in my head. Yeah. I begin.
That image came from God.
Teaching me through that. Yeah, you should teach me through that.
Sometimes God will place, not only give you an image, but he'll show you humor in the middle of a very heavy situation. All right, now. This is funny. Both of these I want to put together because I could picture what you meant. It's like a little child will fold their arms and turn their back. Let me move this chair out of my way. They'll turn their back and, I'm not going to talk to you. And the person, it doesn't make the person disappear. Or like you said, the couple is in the bed together and they're sleeping with their backs to each other. They're both in the same bed. They're right next to each other. It looks silly. It's like two children having a pouting contest. Now, Now this is what happened years ago. I never told you guys this story. When I was in the car with my ex-husband, he had been committing adultery left and right with prostitutes. And he was angry about something I said. And I don't remember what the argument was about. But he was the one who was angry, and I was trying to fight from laughing because he was so upset over nothing. And he put his foot on the brake, and I felt like he wanted to put his foot through the floor of the car. That's how hard he hit the brake. And he pulled the parking brake up, and he jumped out the driver's seat, and he walked, and he kept on walking, and kept on walking, and kept on walking. And I said, okay, well, Lord, what do I do? And I'm just sitting there, and he's gone. And I said, well, I guess he's going to walk home. So I scooted over to the driver's seat and closed the door and drove home. I kept checking, but I couldn't see him. So I drove home. And 2 hours later, he came home huffing and puffing, angry at me because I left him, but he left me. I thought that he was going to walk home. So now I'm trying not to laugh because I didn't know that he was just putting on a dramatic show. And he was, you know, doing a loud pout, so to speak. So the second time he did that, we were at a gas station. And he storms out the car. But this time, he doesn't walk far. This is funny. This is the comical part. Picture this, Andrea. He walks like 20 feet from the car, but he stays in my line of view. And he turns his back towards me and folds his arms like he is just done with me, right? And I'm sitting there snickering with the Lord, saying, Lord, calm him down. This is so silly, right? So he's standing there all upset and bent out of shape. And then this is the comical part. This is what had me rolling. He slowly peeps over his shoulder to make sure I hadn't taken off. Sometimes when we walk with the Lord, then he got back in the car and we went on. But sometimes when we walk with the Lord, we get mad at him, but we don't want him to walk away. We don't want him to drive out of our lives.
That's
the thing. We just want him to know how mad we are right now.
we pout, but we don't walk away too far.
Right.
We're gonna go over here.
Right. I had tears in my eyes. Like, I was laughing so hard.
We are like little big babies.
Yes.
I noticed that sometimes. Like, yes. Oh, man, I'm like a little baby.
Yes. Exactly.
What little people do.
Yeah.
Pouting and stomping.
Yes.
See, all this, that's great, because I'm angry at you, but it's like, that's what we're going to make you upset.
Right. Or you see the person on TV, they show them in an angry scene, and they take something in their hand and throw it up against the wall. Adult temper tantrum. I mean, it's all just like little kids having a little adult temper tantrum. That is so comical.
Oh, except for when adults do it, it's like, break something or...
Yeah. You know, something gets destroyed or major.
Things. I'm starting to realize it's not like a kid, you know, they calm down and, okay, mommy's here. It's like, if you do that at work, you can lose your job. You know, things major. Like that. We got consequences for that kind of behavior, so that's why we have to get it under control now.
Yes.
Say, now you can't be doing all that.
That's right. Peep over your shoulder. Make sure you haven't gone too far, because you don't want that to be gone when you turn around and go back.
Right. I go away.
Yeah. You know, you go back to the job to apologize to your boss, and they hand you the pink slip and say, see ya. Wouldn't want to be ya.
Right.
Yeah, no.
Right. I told you guys this was not one of my most beautiful moments in the world.
Right.
But I told my boss off, walked out the door, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because I was mad.
Mm-hmm.
And I immediately knew, I was like, oh, that's probably not the best thing I needed to do. I was very, I don't know how my other boss was able to get me my job back, but I really almost got fired on the spot.
Wow.
And that would have been justified, most definitely.
Yes.
That I also got that lesson from that world. It's like, whoa, Andrea, you're in the adult world. There's consequences for that kind of crap.
Right.
We don't do that no more.
Mm-hmm. That's why the Holy Spirit gives us the fruit of self-control. And just a little tidbit. I got to share this because it's coming to my mind. For all you parents who think that your children should have freedom of expression, you better pull those reins in now, because you're doing them a disservice. When they grow up, their boss is not going to have the same little, oh, that's my baby attitude. And you will cause your child to live a fully dysfunctional life because they can't hold on to anything because you have not taught them self-control and discipline. Thank you very much. That was fun.